Hi, this is Basha. Welcomes you all.
Here we are going to see the proof of section formula internally. So section formula internally. What is the statement of section formula? The coordinates of the point P x comma y which divides the line segment AB where A is x1 comma y1, B is x2 comma y2 in the ratio m is to n is mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. This is the statement. So diagrammatically you can see here we have a line segment AB. Okay, this AB is divided by P in ratio m is to n. So AP is m, PB is n. Then the coordinates of P will be mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. This is the section formula. How to prove this section formula? Let's carefully look at proof of section formula. So for proving this one, we have a line segment. Let us consider a Cartesian plane. Two coordinate axes, this is x axis, this is y axis, origin. Let us take a line segment AB. This is the line segment AB. So A is x1 comma y1, B is x2 comma y2, and a point P is dividing AB in the ratio m, means AP is m, PB is n. So the coordinates of P consider x comma y. So now we want to find x comma y value. If you find x comma y, that's complete our proof. So this is the diagram. So I want x and y. So to get that x and y, let's draw perpendiculars. From A, draw perpendicular to x axis that you consider as d1. So AD1, same A from P, you drop one more perpendicular, that is d2. From B, one more perpendicular you draw, that is D3. So AD1, PD2, BD3 are perpendicular drawn to x-axis. Okay. So the perpendicular drawn from a point to x-axis is nothing but y-coordinate. So this AD1. So I am writing here, AD1 is equal to y1. PD2 is equal to y, BD3 is equal to y2. Now again same A, I am dropping perpendicular to y axis. From A draw perpendicular, this you take as E1. From P you drop a perpendicular, this is E2. Same A, from B also drop a perpendicular. This is perpendicular, this is E3. So three perpendiculars we dropped here. So the perpendicular dropped from a point to y axis is nothing but x coordinate. Means AE1. AE1 is equal to x1. PE2. PE2 is equal to x. BE3 is equal to x2. Next, from A again I am dropping perpendicular to P, this line PD2. From A drop a perpendicular to PD2. Okay, this give name as C. Okay, so same A, from P drop a perpendicular to BD3. So this is 90 degrees here. This you give name as F. So if you observe diagram, you are getting here two triangles. Two triangles you are getting. The first triangle is APC. Second triangle is PBF. If you observe these two triangles, both triangles are similar. Why? Because angle C 90, angle F 90. Angle C is equal to angle F. That is equal to 90 degrees. Second one, here angle A and angle P, both are same inclination. So corresponding angles. So angle A is equal to angle P, corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. In two triangles, if two angles are equal, then we can say those two triangles are similar. So we can tell triangle APC is similar to triangle PBF. We know that when two triangles are similar, the corresponding sides are in same ratio. So this concept we are taking and we are finding x, y values. So corresponding sides means AP is corresponding to AP is corresponding to PB. And AC is corresponding to PF. That is equal to PC is corresponding to BF. PC is corresponding to BF. So in this way, we have taken corresponding sides are equal. Now we have to find the length of the sides. So I want AC. How AC will come? This you take as equation 1. I want AC. Let's continue with this one. AC is equal to AC, how it will come? AC is nothing but E1C. E1C minus E1A. This total minus this one will give you AC. So E1C means what? E1C. We have seen here E1C. E1C means what here? E1C is nothing but PE2. So PE2 is nothing but PE2, X. That gives you X minus E1A. E1A or A, E1 both same only. So X minus X1 coming. So similar way, find out PF. PF means this length I want. This length if you want means total length. Total length means E2F. E2F is nothing but BE3. So BE3 we have X2. So X2 minus this length we have to subtract. X2 minus X. So similar way you have to find out PC. Here we have PC. So PC find out PC is equal to. So PC means this length I need. PC how it will come? Total length PD2 minus this part you have to remove CD2. CD2 is nothing but AD1. So PD2. PD2 we have Y. Y minus this part. This part means CD2. CD2 means AD1. AD1 is Y1. So Y minus Y1. So next one BF. BF I want to find BF where we have this is your BF. This length. This length how it will come? Total length BD3. BD3 means Y2. BD3 we have here Y2. Y2 minus we have to subtract this part. This part is nothing but PD2. PD2. So PD2 is nothing but Y. So all four values, unknown values we have found. So substitute these four values in equation 1. Substitute these four values equation 1. From the diagram, it is clear that AP. AP is M. So from 1. From 1, AP is M. PB. You can see here PB is N. So M by N is equal to AC. AC means X minus X1 by PF. PF means X2 minus X. That is equal to PC. PC means Y minus Y1 by PF. PF means Y2 minus Y. So this we got. From this any two we can equate. So I am going to equate first two. First I am going to equate first two. So M by N is equal to X minus X1 by X2 minus X. Do cross multiply. Cross multiply means MX2 minus MX is equal to NX minus NX1. So this NX1 take and come, this minus MX take and go. So MX2, this minus NX1 coming means plus NX1 is equal to minus MX coming means plus MX plus NX. So in these two RHS side we can take common X. What will come? M plus N. So here LHS side MX2 plus NX1 we have. So I want X. X is equal to this multiplying factor. N means it will divide. So MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N. M plus N. So I got X coordinate of P. P is nothing but X comma Y. So I got X is equal to MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N. So similarly, if you equate these two, you will get Y is equal to, look at these two. The difference is only here X is there, here Y. X1, Y1. X2, Y2. X, Y. So in place of X, Y coming. So Y is equal to, here also in place of X, you put Y. So MY2 plus NY1 by M plus N. Similarly. So in this way we got X and Y. So the coordinates of P, X comma Y is equal to MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N comma MY2 plus NY1 by M plus N. This is the point which divides the given line segment AB, where A X1 Y1, B X2 Y2 in the ratio M is to N. So this is the proof. So this only they asked. So hence proved. This is internal division. So keep remember this formula, very very useful to solve the remaining problems. Okay. Hope you understand this one. Now we are going to see section formula externally. In previous we have seen section formula internally. What is section formula internally? We have a line segment AB. A is X1 comma Y1. B is X2 comma Y2. P dividing internally means P lies inside AB or in between AB. P lies in between AB. Then it is called internal division in the ratio M is to N. Okay. P is lying in between AB. So this type is called internal division. Internal division. Okay. In this, the P formula will be MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N comma MY2 plus NY1 by M plus N. Okay, so the same condition we are going to use to find external division. External division means same line segment we have here A, B. A is X1, Y1. B is X2, Y2. But coming to external division, P lies extended AB. Means if you extended AB like this, here P lies. Means P lies outside of AB. So in the ratio M is to N. Means AP is M, PB is N. This is the thing happening here. Okay. AP is M, PB is N. Okay, this is called external division. In external division, P lies on extended AB. It will not lie in between AB. It will not lie in between AB. So how to find P here? So let us consider the coordinates of P is X, Y. Okay, so previous formula we know, the point which is internal, which is in between given two points, will be mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. That formula I am going to use. If you observe carefully here, the point B, the point P lies in between A and P. A and P. Here A having, here A having, here P having. It lies in between AB, AP. So P divides, so B divides AP internally. So P, B divides AP internally. So B divides AP internally. In what ratio? Ratio we have to find. Ratio. Ratio is nothing but AB is to BB. That ratio we have to find. That ratio is nothing but M is to N. AB, how it will come? AB. AB means total AP. AP minus BP is to BP we have. BP is N. So AP is M, M minus N is to N. So this is the ratio we got here. Okay, the ratio is now M minus N is to N. Now I want to, I'm going to find X coordinate. So X coordinate of B. X coordinate of B. That is nothing but X2. X2 formula MX2 plus nx1 by m plus n. That is the x to x coordinate of B. So here please note down what is m. What is m? M is equal to m minus n. What is n? N is n only. This ratio you have to take as m is to n. And x1 comma y1 are same. X1 comma y1 only. But x2, y2 are, x2, y2 are, x, y. Okay, hope you understand. This point you have to take x1, y1. This point you have to take x2, y2. So x1, y1, same x1, y1 only. But x2, y2 we have to consider as x, y. Put the values here. The formula is mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n. This is the formula. Okay. So apply the values here. What we have values? M means m minus n. M minus n into x2. X2 means x. Plus n means n only. X1 means x1. By m. M means m minus n plus n. So if you observe carefully, what is happening here? N cancelled. So x2 is equal to multiply inside mx minus nx plus nx1 by m. So denominator m cross end this side, it will multiply. So mx2 is equal to mx minus nx plus nx1. So this nx1 take and come. So mx2 minus nx1 is equal to, in this 2 we can take common x, so m minus n. So this m minus n also send this side, it will divide. So x is equal to mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n. This is the x coordinate of P. Similarly, we can tell, y coordinate will be my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. Okay, in this way we got P x comma y. X comma y is equal to mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n comma my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. This is the section formula for external division. Section formula for external division. You can note that, you can note here, if you put, if you put If you put n is equal to minus n in internal division, we will get external division. This is the important point you can note down. So just in place of n, minus n if you put means external division will come. So in these two, internal division is very, very important.
Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share and subscribe.